Hello and welcome to The Source. I'm Jack.
And I'm Nat. Thank you for joining us. How was your weekend? Did you have a nice time? Did some Christmas shopping? You did too.
I did some Christmas shopping as well.
Hooray, you've got more than
a
candle.
I have. I've got more than a candle now.
You've got two candles?
I've got three.
Four candles. No. We won't do that one again.
Four candles. I can't get into that joke. But how was yours? You cooked Christmas dinner.
We had a Christmas dinner yesterday.
Early.
I know, you know, but, you know.
Christmas isn't...
Well, I wish it could be Christmas. We're just making the most of it around my house at the moment.
Yeah, when it's in December, we have Christmas dinner every day. Because we love Christmas that much. Yeah.
That's a lot of turkey. Should we see what's coming up on the show today?
Yeah, I think we should do
Let's do that.
First up, I'm at the tobacco factory to speak to some of the cast of 101 Dalmatians.
Then I'm checking out the Wardrobe Theatre's Christmas production, Muppets Die Hard.
Then I'm at the Deviled Egg with Barbara to do some Christmas cooking.
Then I catch up with Lucy from the Spiegel tent to find out about their Christmas program. But first of all, Cruella de Vil, Cruella de Vil, if she doesn't scare you,
nobody will.
Cruella!
Should we stop now?
I know, I'm sorry.
I know it's Christmas, but we can't sing that much.
I know.
Just wait until Christmas Day, guys.
It's not a singing show after all.
We're the new voice.
So first of all, Jack went down to the tobacco factory to catch up with some of the cast of 101 Dalmatians.
I'm Lucy Tuck and I'm playing Perdita.
I'm Carla Mendonca and I'm playing Cruella de Vil.
And I'm Tristan Sturrock and I'm playing Pongo. With the Devise show, what we're doing is we're taking the essence of Jodie Smith's book and translating that to the stage. So through the process of devising, we're trying to condense and find the most theatrical way of telling that story. At one point we were talking about using real dogs. But
yeah, we were really excited about not having 101 dogs, but we were excited about the idea of maybe having some real Dalmatian dogs, and every time I've seen them in the street, I feel like dog napping them.
Yeah. At least
them in our show.
Introducing yourself to them.
But that's the wrong character, isn't it?
But what was the reason? It was something to do with health and safety, or?
Yeah, the rules have changed in terms of, and also, you know, there might be someone in the audience who has an allergy and the rest of it. So we moved away from that, but so now we have puppets.
Yes.
Different kinds of puppets.
You have to keep reinventing and finding different, you can't just have one kind of device or conceit to show 101, so you're constantly having to be inventive as to how you show that. And sometimes you go to shorthand and you might see a few, but because everyone pretty much knows that, you know, that's it, the clues in the title. But you can take a few liberties here and there, but then there are certain points where you definitely see 101. But then at other points you might just catch a little glimpse, so it's just...
It depends what they're doing, it depends what the puppies are in the story and in their journeys, what they're doing at that point. And I think what's incredible is that with whichever kind of design decision is made or theatrical decision is made about that capturing that moment, if we believe it, the audience will...
What will they expect?
Well, fantastic music, brilliant music. It's very funny.
And the design, Katie, caught a real kind of flavour of that time. It sort of
1950s, yes, and all those kind of crazy geometrics and lovely patterns.
Yeah,
and
great 50s costumes.
Yeah.
And it's incredibly playful. I think that's the thing. Playful, but it also captures, you know, some real...
The dangers.
The dangers and some of those really kind of heart-wrenching family moments as well. But and there's a beautiful sprinkling of Christmas in it.
Yeah, very much so.
My name's Felix Hayes, and I play Cruella's husband, amongst many things, and a multitude of dogs. There's only a cast of five, so with 101 Dalmatians to portray, we have to be a multitude of dogs. And I'm also one of the Baddens, who are the Baddens.
The Baddens.
And a cow. Yeah. In fact, five cows.
My name's Saikat Ahmed. I play Nanny Butler, who is the butler who helps to take care of the puppies. I also play a multitude of dogs, including Lucky, who's one of the Dalmatian puppies. And I also play one of the Baddons. I play Saul Badden. You can probably tell we play twin brothers.
Yeah. Well, it runs from this Wednesday, which is Wednesday the...
26th? Is it? I don't know.
No, I don't know.
Might be.
Thank you. Yes.
Wednesday the 26th through to January the 11th.
And the best place to find out about the show and get book tickets and things is tobaccofactorytheatres.com with an S.
Yes.
Oh, she looked the part.
She definitely did. She was a bit scary.
Yeah.
Because I've always been scared of Cruella de Vil. And
well,
the serum person.
A really,
you know,
scary character. Beautifully dressed, though.
Yeah, she looked really good.
Yeah, great costumes. I really thought
they were
fantastic.
Really good. Now, though, from puppets to Muppets.
Cool, I like what you did there.
Had that planned for 3 weeks.
The Wardrobe Theatre's Christmas production is Muppets Die Hard. The word on the street is that Muppets Die Hard is the alternative Christmas production to see here in Bristol this winter. And with me are the cast members themselves. Hello, guys.
Hello.
Would you introduce yourselves?
Sure. I'm Andrew Kingston, and I play John McClane, the hero of Muppets Die Hard, amongst others. And this is Mark, who plays one of the FBI agents, Agent Johnson, or Special Agent Johnson, if you prefer.
Hello, Mark. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Lovely handshake.
Thank you very much. And yourself?
I'm Corey Bonner. I'm a Bristol-based puppeteer, and I play Holly Gennaro, amongst others. And this is one of the German terrorists that is in the show.
Hello.
Yeah. Nein.
Okay.
What?
Good. just keep the gun there. It's quite scary.
Yeah, they don't behave, these guys. There's no messing around with them.
So perhaps you could tell me a little bit about the story for viewers at home who might not have heard about it.
Yeah, so essentially it takes the story of the film Die Hard, which is, I guess, a kind of hero against all odds story. You know, the story of one man who rises against this kind of army of terrorists who turn out to be robbers in a massive high-rise building in Los Angeles. There's also a love story as the hero reconnects with his ex-wife, and it's a kind of a classic action romance thriller sort of thing from the 80s. And so the idea of doing that on this very small stage was one that sort of was appealed to us a lot, because we could totally send up the special effects kind of culture of the 80s that then has taken over cinema massively, because obviously we don't have anywhere near that kind of budget or anywhere near that kind of scale. So that's the appeal of Die Hard. And then with our particular version, it's how would, you know, the Muppets, how would they put on Die Hard? So then it's the whole anarchic thread that runs through everything that they do. How would that impact on the story of Die Hard, and how would that translate onto, again, quite a small but unique stage in Bristol?
So thanks very much, guys. Is there anything else that, I mean, I'd quite like to ask you guys, you know, how is it for you being here and performing in Bristol?
Right, well, obviously it's an absolute pleasure for me. I've been a consummate studier of all forms of acting and theatre, and if only Jeremy wouldn't keep messing it up for me, then everything would be so much easier. But he always insists on eating my moussaka and stealing my shampoo.
Mark, you've never even given me any of your moussaka. Look, I've just been going to Motion and Lakota and places like that and partying up with the cool kids, and you stay in every night watching your bloody television programmes.
Yeah! Well, it happens to be that Bristol has its own television station, which I actually enjoy very much, because I get to find out lots about local culture and interesting things, not just nightclubs and places to get a good pizza.
Well, that is one thing we can agree on. It is a very good television channel. Yes.
Yeah, good. I'm glad we are agreed on that. Well, thank you so much, guys. I know you've got to perform tonight, so I might grab one of you to give me a little backstage tour as well before we go. So thank you all. So I thought I'd talk to one of the men behind the scenes here, or perhaps the man behind the scenes, Chris Collier. Hello, Chris.
Good evening.
Good evening. Now, you're one of the you're the director of Muppets Die Hard.
That's right, yes.
Well, congratulations, first of all, on what sounds like probably the most successful Christmas show that you've done here.
Yeah, it's bonkers, actually, how much it sold. I was actually talking to my girlfriend last night about 3 years ago, our first Christmas show we did only sold 200 tickets. We didn't do nearly as many shows, but this is sold about 1,400.
Phenomenal.
It's completely...
Yeah, so this is your
fourth year or third year of doing a Christmas
this
production
is our
here at the Wardrobe?
Christmas production, yeah.
Brilliant. And did you come up with the idea for it? Is it your baby?
Yes. It actually came after the very first one, because the first show we did was a very dark adaptation of Home Alone. So we basically changed the ending, that instead of the burglars coming and setting off the traps, his parents come home and set off the traps, and he accidentally does his parents in. So it's told from the perspective of 30-year-old Kevin McAllister.
Let's see if anyone's home. Hello, it's Corey.
Oh. So these are our elevator doors. We're inside Nakatomi Tower, and the set really provides us with several different places to kind of hide and reveal ourselves from, which is great for puppetry. Yeah.
I can see a load of puppets down here.
These guys are all hung up and ready to go, so when they're doing their party guest scene, they can just flip up and have a little mumble. And we've got smaller characters. This is our small Bruce Willis, who appears after the glass has all been shot, and his feet are very bloody, and he pulls bits of glass out of his feet and goes, ah! And lots of really fun stuff.
Amazing. You've got like terrorists hanging off the wall here.
Yeah, there's terrorists and more terrorists and FBI agents.
Look at them all!
And a little map that reminds us when we have panics where we are in the show. Not that that happens very often, but you know, you just want to...
It's good to know where you are.
Not freak out, yeah.
And amazing.
Down there you can see the small plane, helicopter and van, a very important part of the terrorist coming in and out equipment. This piece of set turns around and it is Nakatomi Tower.
Okay, I'm going to duck out the way here. Look at that transformation.
Yeah, this provides a really nice special effect at the end with massive pyrotechnics. Which make
Huge.
One very, very cute frog very excited. So,
excellent.
It's a lot of fun for the audience.
Well, thank you, Corey. Really cool to see back here and all the little props and everything here on stage at the Wardrobe. So if you haven't heard about it, then obviously you can check the website for details. And if you can, grab some of the last tickets that are available. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you.
There are so many great Christmas productions going on.
I know, it's fantastic. You could be out every night catching them.
You genuinely could.
You literally
be out
could.
Every night.
Yeah, fantastic.
You have so much fun.
So obviously details for that up on the Facebook page. But if you want to join our Facebook competition, you can win two lots of family tickets to see Dick Whittington at the Hippodrome.
It's an amazing show as well, with a great cast, it's really funny, and it's a Christmas panto. Who doesn't want to go to a Christmas panto?
Well, exactly. So if you'd like to win tickets for that, just post your photos of your favourite Bristol moments on our Facebook page, facebook.com/Made in Bristol Television.
Now, though, it's time for a break, so we'll see you very shortly.